gonna be together this Christmas. Fireside blazing bright, we're caroling through the night, and this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Yeah, yeah. Oh, and cars are here. My world is filled with you. This Christmas, and as I look around, your eyes are shining down. They do. This Christmas, fireside is blazing bright.
Kitchen, we're gonna film this all over again. I'm looking for some banana pudding. Okay, all right, we'll see y'all later.
All right, bye-bye.
Can't wait on the food. We're sitting there patiently waiting on the food.
We're sitting in the doctor's office.
They're not getting
stuck with no
needle.
So, this is the season.
They're not getting stuck with no needle.
We celebrate
our Savior,
who was born for the
world. Merry Christmas, fellas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, D.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Jimmy.
Merry Christmas, my baker. My baker. Hey, my baker. Turn around for a minute. Y'all say Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Wait, Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. All right. All right. Merry Christmas, sister.
Merry Christmas.
We got a cake there. Kids are not situated. They ain't got nothing, everything situated, but they get things. So that's looking like potato salad here. That look like that could be a cake right there.
No, that's cornbread.
There's cornbread going on right there too. Yeah, they got the carrot. Okay, we're getting there. Oh yeah, they got the corn going on. Oh yeah, they got the corn going on. Baba, Merry Christmas, Baba. All right, how you doing today? All right. Deacon Miller with you.
They're coming on.
Okay, then. All right.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. And I had it.
Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols.
Yay!
And falls just like Eskimos. Oh, well. everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will
find it hard to sleep
tonight. Yeah, they know that Santa's on the way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies
on the sleigh.
And every mother's child
all right.
is gonna spy to see him reindeer really know.
Merry Christmas, y'all. How y'all doing? Y'all ready to eat?
So I'm offering right, this simple phrase
huh? We got two more
to kids from one to nine.
Say Merry Christmas,
then.
Merry Christmas, ladies. How y'all doing today? Merry Christmas. Y'all ready?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, son. All right, how you doing, Doc? You all right? How's the Lord treating you this week? All right, this is how y'all doing out there. All right, how's the Christmas thing? All right. Merry Christmas, y'all. How y'all doing? Is it Merry Christmas? Come on now.
Yes, it is. Merry Christmas.
All right. Are y'all the halls and halls be jolly and all the reindeers and all that stuff and the Lord is born and all that other stuff and happy birthday Jesus and all that?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Merry Christmas, Deacon. Sister Miller, how are y'all Christmas going this year? Is it a happy holiday Christmas? Is it Jesus was born and all that other good stuff, man? Merry Christmas to y'all. All right, we love y'all.
All right. Y'all need some fun.
Merry Christmas, love, man. You know, we here, we're going to celebrate. We're going to have a good time. We're going to enjoy Jesus. You know, it's his birthday. Y'all know that, right? We celebrate it.
Merry Christmas. Christmas, Sonny, and share. How y'all cooking? Y'all gonna be all right this Christmas?
Y'all celebrating
Jesus?
We're blessed.
Amen. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas,
Happy
everybody.
New Year. You know, Sonny, he just sitting there soaking all that love in. Look how she got her hand. Look, y'all check that out. Look how she got her hand around it. Oh, my God. Merry Christmas, y'all. Merry Christmas, Pauline. And a happy new year. Hope y'all's family is blessed and that the Lord bless y'all real good, okay? Some love ministry to y'all. Merry Christmas, happy new year.
Okay, you know why. And so I'm the president will speak, but I just wanted to say to everyone that this is our first Christmas here in this building. And this is a very special time because, man, it seemed like everybody is just so happy and everyone is just so cheerful and everything. And we have a reason to, because we see where God has brought us from.
Amen. Amen.
From over there, over here. And man, it just everybody is just so happy and we appreciate that. I want to thank everyone that gave me words of encouragement today. I was in the dentist chair yesterday, and every one of them would have been gone except my blood sugar went up, so they had to stop. And they will finish in February, so if you can bear with me to February, then I come back to talking like I always have, but I'm very limited now, so. And plus I have stitches in my mouth too. But I'm not even supposed to be talking because the dentist told me that I don't need to be talking today or tomorrow. But I've been on that radio today and I'm going to be on it in the morning. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, that's what happens when you have a big mouth.
Yeah.
So we're going to do that. I just want to do this before we all hear from the president and we bless the food. But I have a very special reason this Christmas to be joyful, not only because of my Savior's birth, but also because many things have happened in my life this year, and it's for the good, and it has made me a better person, and it has made me a happier person. So I thank God for Jesus for Christmas this year. It's going to be a very special Christmas for me, with not just having Mr. Walter Peavy, but we're having Mrs. Walter Peavy.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, Mr. and Mrs. Walter Peavy.
Y'all jealous people in the back, be quiet. But I want to say from me to you, Love Ministries, Merry Christmas. And have a happy new year. And thank God for this wonderful edifice that he has us in right now.
Amen.
And thank God for each and every one of you.
Amen.
I just want to thank God just for allowing me to be here.
Amen.
I had a little mishap this week, and the Lord, he just kept his arms around me. We was working on a house, and I fell through the ceiling.
Amen. Jesus.
Down to the floor, and all that I got was a couple of scrapes.
Thank you, Lord.
But one thing about the Lord and me and my sister's grandson, we was up on the roof, tearing the roof off, and he was asking me, was all right. So the other day, my daughter called me, Dad, Mama said you fell through the roof. You're all right. I said, yeah, I'm fine. And so they thought I was gonna be all stove up and sore, but all my trust is in God.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
I've had some heartaches. I had some ups and downs from other people. I found out the people that you depend on the most, you forget about that.
My God.
I learned, you said my mama say that there's going to come a time in life when you're going to have to lay down on the Lord. I didn't know what she's talking about at the time because I thought I had a plenty of friends, you know. If you got a ride, you got some friends.
Amen.
And if you got some money to spend, you got some friends.
Amen.
So I found out the hard way that a lot of my so-called friends was getting a free ride off of me.
My Amen. God.
And we used to have parties, and folks would call me and says, "Hey, Michael, sit up. What you gonna get us?" I said, "What you want?" Mm-hmm. And whatever they said they want, that's what I bought. It didn't matter what it cost.
Wow.
Because I thought all them people were my friends.
My God.
And some of them was family. And so, but I found out that my only true friend is the Lord.
Amen. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
I can stand on yes. his promise that he will never leave yes. me, nor will he forsake me.
My God.
And so I'm going to hold fast to him.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And in the meantime, I'm just, it's an honor for me to be a part of this ministry. Mm-hmm. And it's an honor for me to have my companion to Amen. Back me up.
Amen.
Or, because she constantly asks me, "You need some money? You got any money?" I say, "I don't need no money. I got enough money in my pocket to spend." She said, "Well, you don't know what you might need."
Amen. So,
but I just thank God for his grace.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
I thank him for his mercy.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
I thank him for allowing me a chance to be around people mm-hmm. that seem like to me got their feet on the ground.
Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
And I always thank ask the Lord in my prayer, if you ever see fit, if there's any such thing as climbing the ladder,
mm-hmm.
let me go one step, but keep the other foot on the ground.
Amen. Amen. Yeah.
So
Amen.
If I fall, I'm already on the ground.
Amen.
Amen.
And so I found out down through life, if you let them, people will swear your head.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll cause you to mess up.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. And then they'll turn around and talk about you so bad.
Yes.
Until you be too ashamed to stick your head out the door.
Amen.
But I'm glad that the five senses he gave me and the little understanding and intelligence that he gave me, that I can always look to him.
Yes.
And I tell a lot of guys, when I was working, and even around the house, people bring their lawnmowers up there, and I work on them, and they tell me what's the problem. I tell them, I guess. I said, "You know what?" I said, "Daddy made sure that I wasn't scared of no work. He made sure of that." And I said, "Next thing that I believe, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me."
Amen.
I believe this.
Amen.
And the good part is that he ain't got no respect of person.
None.
We the one got them respect of people.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Talk.
But God don't.
That's right.
If a man laid out on the side of the road last night, drunk or whatever, if he woke up this morning, God woke him.
That's right.
Just
yes,
like
sir.
He did you and me.
Yes, sir.
So I'm glad to be around you guys. I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to be able to do something in this ministry.
Amen.
When I leave this side, I want my daughter and my grandkids to have something respectable,
Amen.
To feel something on the inside that daddy and granddaddy was about something.
Amen. That's right, that's right.
And so I don't mind doing what I have to. It don't bother me about doing whatever. If you want to dig a ditch or get down on the ground and lay some pipe or whatever, if I can help, I'm not too good to help.
Yeah, praise God.
A lot of people think a preacher ought to do certain things.
Amen.
But I feel like I'm just a servant.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just a servant.
Amen.
And so I came to serve my Father
Amen.
And my Savior.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
When it come down to Jesus, when it come down to the Father, And when it comes down to the Holy Spirit, there ain't nothing too difficult or too good for me to do.
My God.
And that's in my heart. Yeah. And that's where I want to be.
Amen.
I've been around a lot of preachers, head up in the air, chest stuck out. Feel like it's somebody, I guess. I don't know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
But I look at him and I, you know what I do? I say, Lord, have mercy.
Amen. Amen.
Because I know that I'm nothing but a servant. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter what the Lord have called me to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm intending to do just that. And so while we are coming into this season, let's not, if we can, lend a helping hand.
Amen. Amen.
To somebody, because there's always somebody.
Lost in the valley.
A little bit less fortunate.
Amen.
Than we are.
Amen. Yes.
We might have, I don't have, I would like to have $1 million.
Hmm. Sure enough. Sure enough.
I would like to have $1 million. If I had, all of us wouldn't be here tonight. We'd be on a bus going to Tunica.
Be careful, be careful.
I would give everybody a trip. On me.
Yes, sir.
But since I don't have $1 million, I can open up my heart just like I do.
Amen.
Show some love and concern.
Amen.
But as I was saying, let us all think about why this season is about, what it's about.
That's right.
I tell my family, don't buy me nothing. I don't need nothing. I got plenty, all that I need.
Amen.
And the most thing that I need is more mercy and more grace.
Yes, yes.
And more faith.
Amen.
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 closets full of clothes. So I don't need no clothes.
My God.
So all I need is grace and mercy.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
In the spirit,
that's all right, Pastor Baker.
Praise him,
praise
him,
praise
him,
Pastor Baker.
Yes.
Amen.
He's worthy to be praised.
Yes,
sir.
You know, when I think about how far the Lord have brought me,
yeah,
how He have turned me around,
yes,
that
Lord.
Was a time in my life when people was afraid of me.
My God.
I remember one night, me and one of my friends, we pulled our car across a main highway. Got behind the car with our guns, waiting on some more boys to come over the hill. Anybody could have came over the hill.
Mm.
Amen.
Whatever car came over the hill, we was going to light them up. And that ain't all. That was some stuff that I don't even want nobody to know.
That's right.
Amen.
But God took care of me.
Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him, praise
Him. Amen.
Your past. Amen.
Yes, me too. Sean, that's all right.
He's definitely a good God.
Yes.
I know what you're talking about.
That's
definitely
all
a good
right.
God.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Brought me this far.
Yes,
yes,
sir.
And I don't know about y'all, but I just... can't nobody make me believe that
I
He
know.
Brought me this for me.
I know. Sean, yes, that's all right, Pastor Baker.
David said, I've been young, but now I'm old.
Never seen the righteous.
I never seen the righteous forsaken, nor
never,
have seen
never,
baby
never, never, never,
amen.
Never.
Amen. That's it.
That's right.
And I stand on that.
Yes, sir.
And I stand on also that the Lord is my shepherd.
Yes, sir.
He is my Jehovah Jireh.
Yes.
He's my provider. Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
And so, I know I don't say it too much.
All right.
But anytime I go to talk about the Lord, I can't help myself.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I get a little bit too long.
Yes.
But anyway,
yes, sir.
We hope
know
from my family to you all, we hope that you all have the most joyous, prosperous,
praise
Thanksgiving, Christmas that you ever had in your life.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And this is from our heart, because I can't think of anybody there's some people that put some dirty stuff on me, but I don't even feel any malice in my heart.
Yes,
towards
yes,
it.
Say that.
That's all right.
Say
that's
that.
All right.
And I was telling a person the other day, next to accepting Christ, the next best thing that the Lord did for me was gave me peace on the inside.
Amen.
If you got peace on the inside, yeah, sometimes people get on your nerve, but you know what? If you got peace on the inside, you can step.
All right, Pastor.
That's
all right, Pastor.
You can walk light.
Yes.
Knowing that the Lord won't deny you nothing.
That's right. Amen.
That's people that think we rich. I tell them, no, we ain't rich, but Daddy is.
Come on,
Daddy. Amen.
Daddy have not denied Baker nothing so far.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Whatever. And that's why I tell people a lot of times, people be asking me to do stuff and come help do this. I know there's some of them trying to get over on me.
My God.
But you know what I tell my wife? I said, I'm hoping that they'll do me like people do them, my daughter and my grandkids, like people done me when I was growing up young.
Yes.
And when I got married, I needed this, needed that, and I went to people, and they tell me, said, we don't know about you, son, but said, we know it's your mom and daddy. They always call my daddy Jab, and call my mama Bessie Jab.
Yes.
So we know them. So your mom and daddy did what they say. And they put the finger at me, said, we gonna give you a try.
My God.
You can make yourself or you can break yourself.
That's right. That's right. So, I remember some of them words.
So,
amen.
I tell my wife, I said, I don't care what the people say about me when I'm gone. My siblings going to need something.
That's
as
right.
As long as they get what they need, it's fine with me, because the Lord had already showed me. He carried me to a high place. I thought I was... My blood pressure was up. I know I didn't get up to say all this, but I got to say this. I thought my blood pressure was up, but the whole house went to spinning. And I said, good God, I'm gonna have to get wife kept me to the emergency room. My blood pressure got out of here. And I started floating. But anyway, I floated on up through the ceiling.
My God.
On up and out of space. Mm. And all of a sudden I stood upright. It looked like I was standing on a high hill.
My God.
And I heard this voice say, I want you to open your eyes and look.
My God.
And when I did, it looked like three suns were shining. I had to shield my face. It looked like three suns were shining at the same time. I saw a place so white, bright.
My God.
And this voice said, if you do what I want you to do, when I come for you, I got a home for you over there.
Praise him, praise him.
And then he told me to turn and look. And I turned around and looked. And it looked like if you was on Monsanto, all the lights was out in Huntsville, somebody was standing in the middle of Huntsville with a flashlight. That's how dark and dingy just looked it.
Wow.
The boss said, that's where you come from. But if you do what I want you to do, I got a place for you over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I used to be scared of dying until I saw that.
Yeah. My God.
I ain't scared of dying no more.
That's powerful, Pastor Baker. Powerful.
Man. And then I started floating again, came on down. And when I looked like when I landed on the bed, that dizziness was gone. And I talked to a lady, she said, you had an out-of-body experience.
Amen.
Whatever it was, the Lord made me satisfied.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
So,
amen.
Y'all hold on.
Amen.
Don't let people take your joy.
That's right. Amen.
If you let people take your joy, you're already defeated.
That's right.
My God.
Jesus said, I've overcome the world. So I don't know about y'all, but I already got the victory.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
If I don't let my mind get messed up.
Amen.
And I'm not planning on acting on food. I'm gonna stay with Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Right. I'm gonna stay with the man that I know can give me what I need.
Yes, sir.
And what I need is peace of mind, and I need him to protect me.
Yes.
If I don't worry about no food, I can get out there and pick up me some cans by half on the side of the road. Somebody give me, I come by Miller's house, and I'm like, I know I'm going to get me a good meal. I come by Miller's house, because I know, you know, when we worked on the Austin in the cafeteria out there in the mess hall, I know he know how to cook. Yes. And from what I hear, he got a cooking wife, so.
I'll suck him the most.
You have a third one on it.
God bless you all. And I hope you get everything. I ain't gonna say you want everything you need. Some of them wants get us in trouble.
That's right.
You know, I've seen people ride around in new vehicles and stuff, and they have a tag on the front of it that say another blessing. And then a few days later, I hear them grumbling about the papers. I said, well, what do you think?
Yeah.
If God opened that door,
that's right.
You're going to have to do something.
That's right.
That's right.
He ain't going to bless you with it and make the payments too.
Yeah, so, that's the way.
You know, I've been there when I was working, I bought a van, and I asked my wife, I said, I had about a couple of weeks. I said, what did I buy this for? She said, I guess because she wanted it. I didn't need it. You know, I was like a little kid in a candy store. But I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to be here in you all's company. And I'm just glad to be here, period, on this side of life.
Amen.
So I'm going to say Merry Christmas to everybody. And remember that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
It's not about all of these Black Fridays and all of this stuff. We used to run out and buy stuff and take us a year and a half to finish paying for it.
Thank God.
Mm-hmm. But no more. So God bless you all, and Merry Christmas to all of you.
Well, I'm not a talker.
We know.
But I'm glad to be a part of the Love Ministry. I've enjoyed the time that I've been in here, and I love everybody.
Amen.
I've had some little ups and downs since I've been in it, but everything is all right now.
Amen.
Amen.
And like I said, I enjoy being in here, and I wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
Yes, sir. Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Now it's time to eat, because a lot of people say they're hungry.
Amen.
Some say their stomach's growling.
Amen.
They ready to eat.
Amen.
Who's going to bless the food?
And Pauline going to say something
too? Come on, Pauline.
Going down.
Yes, sir.
Everything going down except the word of God.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Everybody?
I'm just thinking. I think some people think the president wake us up every morning. You know, they blame the president for everything.
Mm-hmm.
But I believe it was Jesus over 2,000 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Took our lives, paid our sin debt, and we bought with a price.
Mm-hmm.
It can't be paid.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. You thank God it's covered in Jesus' blood.
Amen. Amen.
And Pastor Baker said, you know, God's been good to all of us.
Yes, he is.
Man.
I wasn't there when you know, the thing that everybody goes through different storms in life.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Just
but
a
you got to go
Amen.
Through to get there.
That's right. Oh, that's
yeah.
right.
Amen.
Ain't that? We've been so good.
My God.
Ain't nobody better than nobody.
Come on, Doc.
Yeah. We got the same daddy.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
He owned everything. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Whatever we got, he just loaned it to us for a little while.
Yeah.
But I just thank God things well as it is.
Amen.
Because sometimes, you know, we think we can't bear much.
My God.
It's hard to find some Abrahams and some Jobs these days.
My.
Yeah.
You better say that.
But, and we gotta get our hearts and minds ready to take on our before Christmas dinner for this year, the last of this year. I thank Elder Peavy for his vision.
Right.
Amen. Right. That's right.
Sometimes
Amen.
Everybody might not see the same vision, but you can grow into it.
Amen.
Right. That's right.
That's right.
And like Jesus wasn't doing nothing but right, and folks doubted him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But we're not walking by sight, we're walking by faith.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
And somebody said faith is something hoped for, evidence not seen.
That's right. But I know God is able to do anything but fail.
That's right.
But if you hold on, sometimes we get in a hurry.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And we mess up a 2-car field.
Sure enough.
And somebody told me mess up a junkyard, and it's already messed up. But if you wait on God, stand still. Hold on.
Yes,
but
sir.
You got to make a move yourself.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Some people say you make two, he'll make. Oh, you make that first, he right there with you.
Yes, sir.
I mean, I'm tired of him. Have you ever run through the mud sometime and look down at your shoe? He'll pick you up that quick.
Oh, yeah.
Man, we serve a God that's awesome.
Yes, he is.
And don't run out and don't leave no bail out.
Bye-bye.
But we're going to go and bless this food because I ain't eaten since Thursday.
Watch it, Doc. Watch it.
Most holy and everlasting Father.
Yes.
Lord, we just thank you things are well as it is.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. Yes.
Realizing Christmas is not about the mall.
All right.
It's not about roses.
All right.
It is not about what you get. We mm-hmm. got the best gifts of all.
Yes.
And it was free.
Yes.
Thank God for God and his only son.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Looked down in some village and saw a young lady. They were blessed and highly faithful.
Amen.
Yeah.
Although we wasn't there over 2,000 years ago.
All right. All right.
I heard one of the deacons say he was born in 1944, 45. He heard that. Mm-hmm. Well, I heard that I was born in 1946.
Mm-hmm.
What my mom and daddy told me. But the second birth, I know for myself.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
That there was a spiritual thing. It wasn't a going back in the womb and coming back out a second time.
Come on.
If we didn't have to go to nobody at 12 o'clock in the midnight. You know, one thing about it, things happen at midnight.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we wouldn't have to be like Nicodemus. We know for ourselves. We were touched by the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
And thank God that shows grace and mercy every day in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
Realizing we all fall short of God's glory.
Mm-hmm.
But God, his grace is sufficient and his strength it made perfect in our weakness.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, we thank you for the participants, the hands that prepared this food. Lord, we ask for it to be nourishing and strengthening to our body.
Amen. Yes.
And we'll be so careful to give you the honor and the glory.
Mm-hmm.
And we thank you. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And we do thank you.
Amen.
Amen. This is a lamb.
I know what you're doing on this.
Oh, okay. Lamb and child mixed together. Lamb and child. And then my other little was lamb, child, and German Shepherd. And the one that didn't come back. That was the third of them. The German Shepherd, child. I think about it. I think about my daughter.
That's almost time, gift time. We're gonna see what. Excuse me, we don't have to see what we got for our Christmas gifts. I can't wait to see what my gift is. I don't know who gave me a gift. You know what? In the next few minutes, we're coming for praise. We're going to find out who had a gift. So I'll see y'all at gift time, okay?
Yeah.
Walk up.
What is that right there? Lord, that's right.
Bobby,
hey, Robin, look what they got. Open up that candy bar, too. It's something about that.
She'll walk you a pin bar.
All right.
What'd it say? What'd your car say?
Remember, Santa, see you when you're naughty. This is your down payment on your new car, $1 million. Pull your shades and have a Merry Christmas.
You gotta give me a piece of that candy. You gotta open that, Dick.
You gotta give somebody happy
your
candy.
Ooh, that's for good luck. You gotta give me a piece,
please. The president's talking to y'all. Tomorrow is a program here at 5:30
in the
evening.
What you say?
Can we go down? The band of musical here, musical program of the year. And then we're meeting, we'll have Pastor Ford singing disciples. Also, we have we can make it in time. There's two more other groups. Maurice and Company. And Pastor Baker. Amen. And Brenda Young.
That's his card. For the heart of
mankind. Brenda Young. Brenda Young and Company.
Oh, I put Pastor Baker.
Oh,
I'm gonna take it off.
Pastor Baker.
Pastor Baker, they want
this
you over here.
This is from Jimmy Bush.
Deacon Bush. Pastor Baker, come over there and get this, Pastor Baker.
Can we go?
Oh, Pastor Baker. Yes, you gotta open it up too, Pastor. You gotta open it up a little bit. Okay. You gotta open it up. Don't put that on your head, though, Pastor. It's cold outside. There's some other stuff in there, too, Pastor. Listen. Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There's something else in that bag, there too. I thought about that hat though. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm going to have to keep that out of my daughter's face. She'll have a face.
Hey, she can go
down to Bethlehem.
Maybe he'll teach you to get by someday.
If you go down, you can't keep it wrong, man. I'm trying to get you to go down.
Be sure to find Jesus. Let your daddy pray. See where he lived in all his majesty. Go down, be thankful of him. There's hope for you and me.
She don't know who's
in here.
What you got right
here? Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Okay, y'all, I didn't have time to rap them, Auntie Gussie.
In Bethlehem.
I want to thank Brother Bobby Lee for his gift. He didn't know I need some money in my pocket, but hey, look here. Thank you, Brother Bobby Lee. High glory.
Now you can go get what you want.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
You know I needed a child.
go tell it up the mountain.
There you go.
I like that.
Hey,
they got some plaid.
You tell me.